Welcome to Signal and System lecture series. Here in this session, I'll explain unilateral Z transform. So to explain this session, first I'll define what is unilateral transform. Then I'll explain you difference in between unilateral transform and normal Z transform, that is bilateral transform. And then we will solve few examples to understand how to calculate unilateral transform. So see, basically unilateral transform of Z transform, that is happening from limit 0 to infinity, while in case of bilateral or normal Z transform, limits are there from minus infinite to plus infinite. So formula for unilateral transform, that is similar to bilateral transform, only difference is for bilateral Z transform, limits are there from minus infinity to infinity, and for unilateral Z transform, limits are there from 0 to infinity. So if you calculate unilateral Z transform of x of n, then basically that will be summation varies from 0 to infinity x of n z to the power minus n. And when you calculate bilateral Z transform, means Z transform of x of n, then you'll be observing basic formula is summation n varies from minus infinite to infinite x of n z to the power minus n. So basic difference in unilateral transform and Z transform is limits of summation. For unilateral Z transform, it is having summation from 0 to infinity x of n z to the power minus n. And for Z transform calculation, which we have seen already, that is having summation from minus infinity to infinity x of n z to the power minus n. So if you observe the basic calculation of this, then that will be for n is equals to 0, there will be x of 0 z to the power 0 means 1 plus x of 1 into z to the power minus 1 plus x of 2 into z to the power minus 2 and so on. That is how summation is there. While in case of Z transform bilateral Z transform, limits are there in both of the direction, for negative infinity as well as for positive infinity. So this is the basic difference. Now I'll explain you some of the basic Z transform which we have already seen, and how there will be a difference in between a calculation of unilateral transform and Z transform. So see, basically we have seen Z transform calculation for a to the power n u of n, and that we have seen that was Z by Z minus a. We have seen calculation of Z transform for a to the power minus n u of minus n, and that is what Z transform of this signal only, but reverse of this signal. So Z transform of time reversal signal of this, that is this, and for that we need to have Z inverse of this. So you'll be finding this will be Z inverse divided by Z inverse minus a. See, this is what time reversal of this signal. So instead of n we have placed minus n, so this is time reversal of this signal, right? So for that Z transform is minus Z to the power n divided by Z to the power minus n minus a. So this is how it is there. So if you further simplify this, you will be getting this is 1 Z inverse means 1 by Z. So that will be resulting into 1 divided by 1 minus az. So this is about Z transform which we have done already. But now when we calculate unilateral Z transform, so in that case, as I have told, limits are there from 0 to infinity. Now see here, u of n is there. So u of n is having limit which is happening from 0 to infinity only. So for limit 0 to infinity, u of n is there. So there will be no difference in calculation of Z transform for this signal and for unilateral Z transform. So unilateral Z transform, if you observe, for u of a to the power n u of n, then that will be same as bilateral Z transform, as u of n is there means limit is already there from 0 to infinity. Now, when you calculate unilateral Z transform for this signal, a to the power minus n u of minus n. Now see, here u of minus n means what? U of minus n varies from 0 to minus infinity. So 0 to minus infinity, that is what the range which is there with u of minus n. So what will happen is only n is equals to 0 coefficient will be present, other coefficients will not be present. So u of n is equals to 0 coefficient is only present, other coefficients are not present, as in unilateral Z transform summation limit varies from 0 to infinity. For this Z transform, only n is equals to 0 coefficient is available. So for that, all we need to do is x of 0 into z to the power minus 0, that coefficient is available, other coefficients are not available. So if you place n is equals to 0 in this, so you will be getting, this will be a to the power minus 0 into z to the power 0 is 1, so a to the power 0 is even 1, so this will be 1. So unilateral Z transform for this signal, that will be 1 only, as unilateral Z transform is having limit from 0 to infinity. For the case of bilateral Z transform, means Z transform, limit is happening from minus infinity to infinity. So this is the basic difference which is there in between unilateral and normal Z transform. Now I'll consider example so it will be more clear. Now see, we have been given with one example, and question is find unilateral Z transform for x of n, and that is given to us 3, 4, 5, 0, 1, 2, and arrow is given over here. So as arrow indicates here, you can say here n is equals to 0, and if you go in this direction, n is equals to 1 is there, n is equals to 2 is there, n is equals to 3 is there, and if you go in this direction, n is equals to minus 1, n is equals to minus 2 is there. So as we have seen the basic formula of unilateral Z transform of x of n, that is summation n varies from 0 to infinity x of n z to the power minus n, unilateral Z transform of x of n, that is summation n varies from 0 to infinity x of n into z to the power minus n. So here we don't need to consider this coefficients, as we don't have that in limit over here. So this coefficient will not get considered, only this coefficients will get considered in calculation. So basically this will be x of 0 plus x of 1 into z to the power minus 1 plus x of 2 into z to the power minus 2 plus x of 3 into z to the power minus 3 plus x of 4 is not there, so I don't need to write. So x of 0, that is 5, plus x of 1, that is 0, so 0 into z to the power minus 1 plus x of 2, that is 1 into z to the power minus 2 plus x of 3, that is 2 into z to the power minus 3. So basically this is 5 plus z to the power minus 2 plus 2z raised to minus 3. So this is how we can calculate unilateral Z transform. And if there is a question based on what is Z transform of it, so Z transform for this same sequence, that has to be summation n varies from minus infinite to infinite x of n z to the power minus n. So where we need to consider minus infinite to infinite means all coefficients will be available here. So here, as for this range, limits is happening from minus 2 to 3. So I need to write x of minus 2 into z to the power 2 plus x of minus 1 into z to the power 1 plus x of 0 plus x of 1 into z to the power minus 1 plus x of 2 into z to the power minus 2 plus x of 3 into z to the power minus 3. So now we can place this coefficients here. So this is 3 into z square plus 4 into z plus 5, and x of 1 is 0, so I don't need to write it. X of 2 is 1 into z to the power minus 2 plus x of 3, that is 2, so plus 2 z raised to minus 3. So you can clearly observe what is the difference which is there in between these two, unilateral and bilateral z transform. So this is how we can calculate unilateral and bilateral z transform. I hope that you have understood the difference in between unilateral and bilateral z transform, and I wish you can be able to calculate examples based on this if it is coming in your examination. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please do give your valuable suggestions. Definitely based on it, in future I'll make videos which will be solving your queries. Thank you so much for watching this video.